Diabetes research supported by NIDDK has led to many groundbreaking discoveries to help adults and youth prevent, delay, and manage this chronic disease.
The 1921 discovery of insulin meant that for the first time in history, children diagnosed with type 1 diabetes could live to adulthood.
Over the past 100 years since insulin was discovered, there has been a lot of medical research and discoveries that have contributed to more precise diabetes care. We have more precise ways of measuring and monitoring blood glucose that has improved from the pretty rough ways we used to measure levels crudely in the urine to using test strips and glucose meters to now having continuous glucose monitors.
The landmark NIDDK-supported Diabetes Control and Complication Study, or the DCCT, and its follow-up study, the Epidemiology of Diabetes Interventions and Complications, or EDIC, showed that keeping blood glucose levels as close to normal as safely possible is key to preventing the long-term complications.
For more than 40 years, we conducted a longitudinal population study in the Gila River Indian community in Arizona. This study was focused on the predictors and development of diabetes and its complications, and it led to understanding some of the risk factors for diabetes that ultimately led to diabetes prevention studies. The DPP looked at whether a lifestyle intervention or the medicine metformin would delay or prevent type 2 diabetes. The lifestyle intervention in the program reduced the incidence of diabetes by 58% during the main three-year study. Metformin was less effective, but had very long-term benefits in terms of weight loss and diabetes prevention.
A diagnosis of diabetes can be very different for different people. And it's not just the presentation of diabetes that can be different, but also its prognosis. We know that certain ethnic and racial minority groups with type 2 diabetes have a greater risk of developing complications of diabetes like retinopathy and nephropathy compared to non-Hispanic whites. I see precision medicine as being critical for enabling better person-centered care.
I decided to volunteer for a clinical trial after attending a diabetes conference that I went to shortly after my diagnosis of type 1 diabetes as an adult. I really felt very hopeless about diabetes. I was frightened of what the treatments involved. I was worried about what my future would look like, all of those types of things. But participating in these trials really has given me a sense of hope as far as the future of living with diabetes. The encouragement of knowing that there are so many people really devoting their entire careers to research in order to improve the lives of people with diabetes. It really does feel like I have an audience or a large support group behind me, cheering me on.
Research has enabled us to better understand and manage diabetes, delay type 1 diabetes, prevent type 2 diabetes, and it's really moved the illness over time from a devastating and nearly always soon fatal disease to what is now a very manageable chronic condition. NIDDK's continued investment gives hope through research, and we are dedicated to build on the progress that has been made since NIDDK was founded.